Hello friends, welcome to our YouTube channel. Now today we are going to discuss about the differential equation of the simple harmonic motion. Okay, so how to derive it, we'll see in today's lecture. So first of all, you observe this diagram. In this diagram, an object, it is tied with a spring and it is performing the simple harmonic motion. So when we drag this object with a displacement x in one direction, the force acting on it will be directly proportional to x. Okay, it is direct. Simple harmonic motion means the force, it is always directly proportional to its displacement. But in the opposite direction, so we are getting here F is equals to minus kx. Okay, it is about the x axis. So according to this diagram, we are getting force is equals to minus k into x. Now we will use the concept of the velocity and the acceleration. As x is the displacement here, if we find the velocity, we will get here velocity is equals to dx by dt. And from this, what is acceleration? Acceleration will be dv by dt, that means d2x by dt squared. So acceleration, it is nothing but the second derivative of the displacement. Okay, so A is represented as d2x by dt squared. Now we apply here the Newton's second law. According to Newton's second law, the force acting on an object, it is mass into acceleration. So we will use here F is equals to m into d2x by dt squared. This is the force. Now according to our concept of simple harmonic motion, force is equals to minus kx. Minus due to its opposite direction and x displacement. And it is directly proportional, so proportionality constant is k. So force is equals to minus kx from the simple harmonic motion concept, and F is equals to m into d2x by dt square from the concept of Newton's second law. Now these two relations will give us information about the force, so we can equate these two equations. So after equating these two equations, we are getting here m into d2x by dt square is equals to minus k into x. Now solve this. Minus k into x will come here, it will be plus k into x is equals to 0. Okay, so here we are getting equation as m into d2x by dt square plus kx is equals to 0. So further we simplify this. How to simplify? Divide the whole equation with the m. Okay, so when we divide the total equation with mass m, we will get here d2x by dt square plus k upon m into x is equals to 0. Okay, now k divided by m, it is the constant, that is omega square. Okay, so here we have to substitute here k by m, it is nothing but the omega square. So we are getting ultimate relation as the d2x by dt square plus omega square x is equals to 0. This is nothing but the differential equation of the simple harmonic motion. d2x by dt square plus omega square x is equals to 0. So this equation represents here the differential equation. Okay. Now according to the second equation, we have substituted some value, that is nothing but the force is equals to mass into acceleration. So we are substituting here in this equation m into a, and acceleration according to this, it is omega square into x. So we are getting again force is equals to minus m omega square x. Okay, acceleration is a second formatic use kela omega square x, but f is also minus k into x. So again we, from this equation, we can get k minus kx is equals to minus m omega square x. And while we solving this, k is equals to m into omega square. So from this relation, we are getting the k by m is equals to omega square. So how we are getting, or how we are substituting in the previous equation, that is the reason given here. Okay. So this is the simple concept, k by m, it is omega square. How we find, this is the supplementary and the main expression that in previous slide we have completed. Okay, so hope you understand this differential equation, how to derive for simple harmonic motion. If you have any doubt regarding any step, please comment here. I will explain that. If you like our video, share it.